Can a MP who's being accused of sexual depravity of the worst kind in the history of the country, over 2,000, 5,000 videos they say are in public domain, and most of these women are being forced and by misuse of power, how can a sitting MP or BJP ally be permitted to leave the country without the consent of Home Ministry and an External Affairs Ministry? Obviously, Modi government is involved. And why is Mr. Yeddurappa silent? Why is Sumanlata ji today silent? Why is Shobha Karanje silent? Why is Smriti Irani silent? Why is Mr. JP Nadda silent? Why is Mr. Amit Shah and Mr. Modi silent? Why is Mr. Vijendra silent? Why are they not coming forward and saying that they have also committed a sin by allying with such a person?
Kumar Swami, in fact, who is the relative of Prajwal, says that we are not here to protect anyone. The law will take its own course. If someone has committed crime, they will be brought to justice.
Well, it is the same Mr. Kumar Swami about him. His father, our old respected leader, Shri Deve Gowda, had said that if Kumar Swami ever wears a shawl of the BJP, he will disown him as his son. And it's better for Kumar Swami to commit suicide than to ally with BJP. They have double standard and duplicity. Again, they are standing shamelessly on the stage of the BJP after having said extreme things.
Once the investigation starts, and if it's proven that Prajwal in fact was indeed in the videos and did commit the crime, would the government not or would have the courage to go catch him wherever he is and put him behind the bars? Would you give that message to the people of Karnataka?
No, absolutely. Our Chief Minister, Mr. Siddharabhaiya, and Mr. D.K. Shivkumar have said, there will be a fair investigation. Every victim can come forward and issue a statement or make a statement. And there will be no political one-upmanship in this. There will be a free and fair investigation. But the question is, why is PM silent? Why is Amit Shah ji silent? Why is Yeddurappa and Vijendra silent? Why is Shobha Karanje, Smriti Irani, Sumanlata ji, why are all of them silent? Why are they not coming out as also condemning such depraved acts by their ally MP? And why did Prime Minister go and campaign in Hassan, knowing fully well that all these videos were out in public domain, being placed before Prime Minister and Amit Shah by BJP leaders themselves, who were saying that don't have an alliance and don't come campaign and don't go give ticket to such a person?
My question was about itself. One of the candidates of 2023 BJP, Hole Narsipura, had written to the state BJP saying, do not have an alliance with JDS because there is a news about him having videos of women in on a pen drive, and yet the BJP did an alliance with them. Now do you challenge them to break off the alliance? What is your point of view on this
letter? I am saying that Prime Minister must break his silence. I humbly request him, please break your silence. Mr. Amit Shah must break his silence. Mr. Yeddurappa and Mr. Vijendra must break his silence. And Prime Minister must also inform the country. Amit Shah ji must inform the country whether Prajwal Ravanna has left the country. If he has left, how did he leave? What was Home Ministry and External Affairs Ministry doing? Why was he permitted to leave? And why are they not saying a word?
We have got information that he has left to Frankfurt.
Yes, this is what I'm saying. Yeah. Even India Today has that information. It's circulating in public domain. Yes. Can anybody leave for Frankfurt? He has to go through Indian passport control, no? Then they know what is happening. Why? And it's a MP, so obviously it raises an alert. Why did Government of India not stop him? And it's Government of India that has to now bring him back. So Modi government has to tell us, by when will they bring him back, so that all the samples can be taken and then prosecution can start. Yeah. Otherwise, it's a very convenient way to freeze the entire investigation.
No, I'm asking this again and again because in Karnataka, there's a saying that everyone's friends with everyone. All 224 MLAs are friends with everyone. Congress, JDS was an ally of Congress back 5 years back. Now they are with the BJP. This friendship would not come in between the investigation, is what I want.
No, absolutely not. See, BJP may treat Congress as an enemy. We treat them as a rival political party. They are not our enemies. We just represent two different streams of thought. That's all. So even Mr. Yeddurappa and Mr. Siddharamaiah, Mr. Yeddurappa and Mr. D.K. Shivkumar, they are not enemies. We don't treat them as enemies. Rahul Gandhi ji, in fact, went and hugged the Prime Minister. We don't treat Prime Minister as our enemy. He is our rival. whose thought process we don't agree with. Our vision of India is completely different than the vision of BJP. But when it comes to law and giving justice, our Chief Minister has assured, and have faith on his word, that justice will prevail and it will be free and fair.
Another issue that Prime Minister, whenever he comes to Karnataka, speaks about the reservation here. He says that Congress in Karnataka wants to take away SCST OBC reservation, give it to the Muslims. There's already a 4% reservation. They want to implement this model across India if they come to power. So he's urging the Dalits and OBCs, look through the manifesto.
May I point out to you, yesterday he didn't say it in Karnataka.
Yeah.
You know why?
Earlier he had said it, yeah.
You know why? Because he realized that as Chief Minister, he has ruled Gujarat for so many years, and Muslims there also has OBC reservation of a limited time. And anyway, the matter is now in the Supreme Court and is sub judice. Everybody knows about it. So these are non-issues, if I may say. Who is going to deny reservation to SCST, OBC and is attacking the Constitution? You saw Mr. Hegde's statement.